guys, welcome to my very first house update video. I'm gonna take you guys along the journey of my family and I as we build our home. Today, I'm gonna talk all about finding the lot, getting the house plans, finding our builder, and where we are at right now. And then, so this video is gonna kind of be longer of that whole process, but from here on out, I'm going to do small, short updates, whether it's doing kitchen cupboards, finding the carpet, I'm gonna be showing you colors and swatches, just the whole process. So make sure to subscribe to follow along our journey, and let's get started. A little disclaimer before we start, all of this information has been purely my experience. So don't take it as a fact, like this is how it is. This is just how my husband and I have done it, and this is our experience here in Utah. The first step I think to make is whether you build or buy a home. My husband and I got a realtor and we walked through about 10 to 15 different houses. And after walking through the houses, we thought we wanted to build our home. We knew the location we wanted to be somewhat close to my sister, and we knew the kind of home we wanted, and so we decided, let's build our home. After deciding that we wanted to build our home, we were driving all over the place. We put mile after mile on our car. We drove and looked at lots. We looked online, we called builders, what lots do you have, where are they located, how much are they? We looked everywhere for a lot. We looked at the community, we looked at the neighbors. Jared and I even knocked on people's doors. We knocked on their doors and said, how's the school district? How is the church community? How are your neighbors? We knocked on a lot of doors, and everyone that we knocked on was extremely nice. Everybody was helpful. And then we walked through this neighborhood a few times, and we just kind of didn't stay. We just kept going because we thought, oh no, we probably won't do that. We kept going back to this one specific lot that we really liked. Jared and I are here at the lot and we are waiting for the last person to come and give us a bid or quote on how much it might be to kind of landscape this, excavate it, kind of flatten it out. Every time we kept going back to that lot, the neighbors would come out and they would talk to us. They would say, oh, are you gonna buy the lot? The neighborhood's great. There were so many kids. That's one of the things that I loved about it, was there were so many young kids for my young kids to potentially have friends and grow up with. Every time we went into that neighborhood, kids were riding their bikes. They were playing. They were even like nice to us. They would say hi and wave. So we found the lot that we loved. We found the neighborhood that we loved. And so we decided to buy that lot.
Getting we just sore. Signed four papers. It is officially.
It's official.
After buying our lot, we figured, what house are we gonna put on this? We kind of had an idea of what we wanted. We wanted at least two bedrooms upstairs, an office, and the laundry area upstairs, and at least two bedrooms downstairs for our growing family. So we started looking at house plans online. We just Googled house plans. I think houseplans.com. We looked at Pinterest. We looked at Google. We looked at magazines. Any house plans we kind of looked at just to get an eye of what we wanted. After we figured out about what kind of home we wanted, we didn't take the process lightly. We didn't want to just jump in and grab a builder and build a home. I think no matter what builder we chose, we would have gotten a good home. But we interviewed at least six different builders. We interviewed builders because we wanted to be able to trust them. We wanted to be able to communicate with them. We wanted to see the quality of work that they had in their homes. Every builder that we interviewed had model homes that we would go in and look at their model home. A lot of the builders would give their previous homeowners gift cards, like, hey, they'd call them up, hey, can we give you a $30 gift card and bring someone in through the house? And they had built the house a year ago, but they kind of knew the style we wanted, so they would call the previous builder, and of course people would take the gift card and say, yeah, come in, and we would walk through the home to see the quality of what the builder had built and to kind of see different house plans that they had built. Every builder that we interviewed also had their own house plans, so we could look at the house plans and choose what different builders had different plans, what worked for us. The interviewing process was very interesting. As we were in the middle of purchasing our lot, we had started the interview process. And so, like, we were kind of doing everything hand in hand. And one company was very discouraged and didn't want us to buy the lot that we wanted to buy because there was a lot of work to be done in the yard. It needed excavating, lots of rock work. It just was a ton of work. And they kept telling us, you know, you probably don't want to build there. There's, you know, a lot of money is going to be put in it. A lot of time is going to be put into it. Maybe you should, you know, look at a few lots down that are more flat surface. But that's not what we wanted. We wanted that lot. That's the lot we wanted. That's the envision that I had for my backyard. And so it just was interesting to me to have a builder company discourage me from that, whereas the other builders were all for it. So I don't know why they discouraged me from it. I think the biggest reason was they just said it was a lot of work to do. Another interesting experience we had was the house across the street from the lot that we were in the middle of purchasing. We loved the home. We knocked on her door. They had just built it like a year ago. And she's like, do you guys want to come in and see it? And of course we're like, yeah. So we walked through, we looked at the house. We loved the work. We loved how she designed it. And we set up an interview with that builder at our lot like a week later. And we said, oh, we love that home across the street. You guys did a great job. We would love something kind of like that, but change this and do that. And he was almost like Debbie Downer. He was like, oh, I would never want to build that house again. That was awful. Like the homeowner loved it, but the builder didn't love building it. And it just was interesting hearing him talk so negatively. It just didn't go very smoothly with Jared and I. So again, the second builder, we cut off the chopping block and continued to interview some more. So it came down to picking the two builders. One was a track home builder and one was a custom home builder. And we had a house plan with each of those people that we liked. So we continued the interview process. We went to the track home builder and we sat down. My mom was there for that one. We sat down, we looked at the plan. I loved the plan. And I said, the only thing I really don't like is the bathroom. I'd love to move the bathroom here, rotate the toilet, rotate the tub, make it a little bit more open. And he said, you know, that's gonna cost about $6,000 to $8,000. And you should have seen my mom's face, because my mom has built every home she's lived in, and she goes, it's not gonna cost $8,000. The bathroom's not even there to move. So how would it cost $8,000 to move? And it just was very interesting. He just explained that this is how the house plans are, and that's what you get. And if you make any changes within it, it's going to cost money. And he said, so if you make more than one or two changes, you're gonna wanna do the custom home build because it won't cost as much, because they allow you to customize it. Whereas our plans, this is our plan and this is what you'll get. So that was interesting to me to actually sit down and listen and figure out the whole process, because I really liked that home. So then the custom home builder, I had a house plan that I liked with him. But the same thing, the bathroom, I wanted to change it up. I wanted to move it, make it more open. And his words to me were, it is your home, do what you want. As long as it's on the inside of the house, you can make whatever changes you want. Take note that this was my situation with this custom home builder. I don't know if that's with everyone, but from what I understand with all the interviews that I had done, that was the case with all the custom home builders that I had talked to. So Jared and I decided to go with the custom home builder, and he's actually the same builder that built my mom's home 20 years ago. So that's been really fun for my mom as well to follow the process, because it's like she's reliving her process of building her home as well. As far as house plans go with the custom home builder, you can go in and say, this is what I want, and they can sketch it up and draw it up and make you a whole plan just for you. But with what I did was I went to him, just like the other builders as well, I went to him and I said, you know, I want two bedrooms upstairs, I want an office, I want an open concept, I want the laundry room next to the kitchen, I want at least two bedrooms downstairs. Like, I told him what I wanted, the cold storage under the porch, and he said, you know, I have a house that I think you'll like. So he pulled up a few of his house plans that he had previously done and said, I've got this, I've got this, I've got this. And I said, ooh, I love that one. I said, the only change I'd make in that one is the bathroom. So that is what we ended up choosing. We actually took out a kitchenette downstairs because I just thought, I don't want to add a kitchenette downstairs. I got little kids. Maybe in the future, if we want to install that, we can. But I ended up going with that house plan. So what my builder has done was he gave me a price for the house and everything in it, and he gave me a breakdown. So he has an email of, go to this place for the kitchen, go to this place for the tile, go to this place for the roof shingles, go to this place for the rock, and he has a price of the breakdown of the house. So I have X amount of money to go pick out kitchen cabinets, I have X amount of money to go pick out carpet, and if I go over on my budget, that is my fault. So if I have, let's just say, I don't know, $10,000 for hardwood floor, and I choose the most nicest hard floor, and it's like $15,000, then I have to pay out of pocket the $5,000 because I went over. So we have not picked out anything yet for the inside of the house. You guys are gonna come along for this journey. Right now, as we sit, we are just finishing up the bank and the builder. They are getting the lot appraised. They are finishing up the construction loan. And so literally any day, I'm just waiting for a phone call saying, tomorrow we can dig. So that is where we stand right now. As we are waiting for the house, I decided that I wanted to hire an interior designer. Somebody to not pick out my stuff for me, but somebody to help me steer in the right direction. I know that I want this color and I want these kind of tiles, but I want to make sure it goes well together. So that is going to be a really fun process to work with somebody and bring her along as we go pick out items for the house. And for the interior designer, that was a whole interview process in and of itself. I had 4 designers, I called them, I interviewed them. If they didn't have Instagram, I didn't even call them. I thought, if you don't have Instagram, I'm not hiring you to be an interior designer for me. So you have to keep up with the times. So I found somebody that I really like and that I really trust. So I'm excited for this whole process. My next video will be us digging our hole or us picking out our kitchen cabinets, whatever comes first. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you want more information between tract homes, custom homes, there's so much information. I'll have a link down below that I found a really good website that explains it all. Some of you guys have had questions about that, so that'll be down below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys.